Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Betrayal at Krondor! Where we last left off, we had just escaped from Sargoth, and... yeah! So, that's good. So let's poke around a little bit here. So we are, as you can see, kind of in the far north of the map now, so we did get past this... snow collapse, avalanche, whatever you want to call it. And we have a whole bunch of stuff to explore here, so I think that's probably what we're going to be doing mostly this episode, is just kind of poking around. Damian Mozatik suggested that I find Nalar's rib. He said it is in the area around Sargoth, and having it will make things a lot easier on me. So we're going to poke around, see if we can maybe find that. Ideally, it won't be too much trouble. I don't know really what to expect with regards to enemies and stuff around here. But, I mean, we still have, you know, our spyglass, so we can at least use that. So there's something out here somewhere. We also have a graveyard. Nice. Oh, and a lone Morad Hall. Oh, but they've seen us. Oh, there's a group of them. I was not expecting more than one! Alright. Well... I'm debating on how I want to go about this. Like, flame cast, like, throw a fireball in is always nice. Spare the eyes. Actually, I have an idea. Where is it? Is it Dan's Delusions? Yes. We'll just create an illusion of you. I'll choose a target, is you. And then here. There. I was hoping she wouldn't act next. I was gonna have Gorath charge her, which I'm gonna have him do anyways. Yeah, that needed to happen. Oh, seriously? Seriously, dude, seriously, get out of here. I'm gonna hit him with, I think this is the pocket sand, right? Yes. Shishisha! All right. Gorath, begin your dark work. Owen, just find somewhere else to be. Okay. Shouldn't, in theory, be too bad. Oh, come on, Gorath. You just need to hit him. Oh, my lord. I hate you, Gorath. Any damage you saw? Seriously, he's missing. Freaking 90% chance to hit and misses four times in a row. That's some bullshit right there, guys. All right, let's lock this last guy down so that we can rest. We'll just go for maximum paralysis here, and everybody can just kind of heal up. Freaking absurd. They really, really need to just not give you the numbers if they're going to be that just wholly inaccurate. I don't know, guys. I don't know. I keep looking out my window. I apologize if I'm silent. It sounds like it's like pouring rain outside, but it's not, and I don't know what it is. It's freaking me out! Okay, so this guy doesn't really have too much on him that's of value right now. A whetstone, which our gear is fine. See, ours has 14 uses, and I think his has, what, 6? 10. Some rations that are poisoned. We are gonna avoid those. Is that you? Yeah, that was you. All right. So now I gotta, no. Gotta finagle with positioning here. So I can access the rest of these bodies. Ooh, some gold. And this is defense, right? Yes, we will take that. Give that to Gorath using his last free inventory space. And some flame root oil, which we do have some, so I'm gonna see if he can stack that. He can. Excellent. All right, so I'm not gonna be digging up graves, although I suppose a rib would possibly be found in graves, huh? I don't know, do we have a shovel? Do. Tempting! Alright, so there's some stumps down here. Oh. The trap? I didn't see any enemies. Oh, there's enemies. All right. And we apparently got bushwhacked, which is just wonderful. Gorath, I hate you. All right, well, I guess since we're doing this, we can see how this thing works. If they're gonna have Owen cornered, lightning-based death. It's only 40 damage, like it's, it's not bad, don't get me wrong. And I'm certain that there are situations where it could come in handy. But like for this, since it doesn't one-shot them, and they seem so happy to be just filling Owen with crossbow bolts, I think there are probably better things I could do with his actions. Ha! I think that one missed Gorath and hit this dude in the back. That is some gold right there. I'll take it. All right, we're gonna despair the eyes. We'll go for... We're gonna just lock this guy down. He's gonna be the one that we're... Oh my God. Gorath just got two turns in a row there. I don't know how that works. Owen's gonna end up dead here. We're not careful. Oh, he's poisoned, I think. Yeah. Let's see, eat the berries. Freaking elves and their poisons. Typical. All right, there we go. Now we can just rest. We should have enough time, and if we don't, I'll just lock this dude down again. So I'm not really too particularly worried about it, honestly. Come on, Owen. Continue healing. Save those rations for me. High action gameplay. Should be... All right. So he should be good. Gorath can't hit a paralyzed target. Yeah, I didn't even see those guys. I don't know where they came from, but they're all piled in front of me now. Let's see, we'll take the money. We don't have any room for stuff. I need to find a shop. So what do we have here? 16 uses. All right, that's better than our whetstone. So we'll trade. Actually, what I should do is here. We have ours. We use ours. There we go. Get rid of this one. Take the new one. These rings are worth typically about 100 gold, so I would like to take that. I think I'm probably gonna take that over crossbow bolts. And we'll see what else these guys have. All right, so that was the one I just looked at. What about you? Just some rations, a crap load of rations. Some more money. Poison bolts, do we have poison bolts? We do not, we have flaming bolts. More poison. Ooh, what is that? An elven crossbow. 25 plus squirrel skill for damage. Not bad. What is in this? 79 royals. Alas. A shell of 70 quality. I don't know where that's gonna be value-wise compared to, you know, arrows. See, what do we have in this one? Oh, another emerald of 4 quality. So this thing probably isn't worth too much, but still, let's drop some stuff here. I'm gonna drop the flaming quarrels, and I think the sword of Kinnur. I'm sure people are probably raging that I'm holding onto this dragon plate armor, but damn it, I need to. It's important to me, okay? Here, actually, for the time being, I'm gonna have Gorath repair this. There. Oh, our repair hammer is done. Crap. All right. So take that. So yeah, we have 2 squares of space. That should suffice. I'm gonna take both of these. I mean, I could probably go back to Sargoth and sell some of my valuables, but they're very obviously not paying me a lot for them, but I really need the inventory space. So I think for the time being, We're just gonna have to kind of suck it up, I think. Alright, and of course, as soon as I sit down to record, my phone elects to go off. I'm muting it. I apologize for that. We can buy armorous hammers here, which is good. This guy also sells rings of Prandor, which means this isn't gonna be, as I say, worth nearly as much as I'd like. 13 sovereigns, 100 sovereigns. Alright. 2 sovereigns. Alright, so shells just, I guess, aren't worth it. How much are you giving me? 170. Fine. Damn it. What is this? Ring of the Golden Way. I think that gives us, like, luck or something. No use. No use. So we want another armorer's hammer. 26 gold. That's pricey. I actually think these powder bags... No, I don't want to sell it. I want to go back in here. I think I'm going to actually buy him a second powder bag, because that, just based on this first one that I've had here, like, that's already... That's doing work. So let's see. I'm going to save, because, you know, we've made progress. And then I guess we're going to do some grave robbing, maybe? I don't know. Let's see here. Save. High action gameplay. All right, so now, like I said, I wanna poke at these graves. I mean, like, if you're gonna be looking for a rib, I guess, you know, digging up bodies isn't terrible. Oh, looking from one headstone to the next. Owen was horrified that they bore either his or Gorath's names. How can they have made these stones so quickly? They are possessed of an evil magic, these stones. They are known as the Terror Stones. Condemned of Sargoth are sometimes on the eve of their execution brought to this place and interred, so their head remains above ground. Until the time they are to die, they gaze onto their names and often go mad. I can only assume Delacon intended that we were to be brought here. After people are executed, are they buried here? We are like unto the Elidhal in our ways of the dead. Once a Moradhal falls in death, that which lies upon the ground is a living thing no more, only rotting meat, unworthy of further attention. Only when we intend great insult do we inter our kin. Alright. So is that... Yeah, Gorath of Greenheart Clan. Owen Belafort. Oh, they're all... His human blood made him weak. Gorath lay with the beasts. Betrayed his people, choked to death on his own blood, died on his knees. Alright, so these are just... Those are the stones of douchebaggery right there, that's what those are. See, so let's camp until... Wow, I love it. We sleep for like 2 hours until healed. Alright, so I believe there was something on my map, like out this way somewhere. I'm gonna go ahead and use this again. No, it is not. It is actually behind us. And it would be against... Oh, it's a couple more at all by the look of things. Yes, alright. Well, there's only 2. Huzzah! The enemy was not surprised. One of these days, we'll actually surprise a group of enemies. And they won't outnumber us 3-1. Oh my lord, I'm gonna go ahead and throw Dan's Delusions. This spell is surprisingly useful. Just drop it like right there. Hey look, there's a mage on Owen's poison. Ha! You just ate a crossbow bolt with his back. I appreciate that. Owen. He's gonna lose his turn. Yeah, that irks me that if you go into your inventory and leave, cause I was like, maybe I should eat the berries for cure poison. But then, you know, the thought struck me, well, he'll just get shot again and it won't have mattered. Whereas, like, I just did it right there, where I was going to do it again, but for whatever reason, my brain's like, Gene, don't do this. You need to just have him throw some stunning magic on people, which is what I'm gonna have him do. Thousand knights, 15 rounds on you. And Gorath, go forth and kill. Oh no, my illusion's worn off, but just in time. In the meantime, eat some berries. anti-poison berries are a lifesaver. All right. Back into the melee here with Gorath, and we'll just give Owen a chance to heal up, and then we'll finish this with great violence. Okay. I hate you, Gorath. You have an 80% chance to hit. Ugh, this game. All right, what do we have here? Some rations. I mean, I suppose, like, since we're so close to town, we can probably just afford to grab all of this crap because we're just gonna sell it immediately. Because we are, like, literally just outside of town. All right, so nothing on either of these really of particular value. Where are the other corpses at? Like, I just did a full 360. Oh, no, that one's hiding behind another one. Oh, this is a crap tier crossbow right here. Another sword of Knur. That's a Gorath. Some arrows. Let's see. That looks like about it. Oh, there's something to our south and west. Or actually, it would be west and north. Right back along this. Ah, here we go. Ah, more doll boxes. All right, let's fail. Held firmly in the hands like a sword, it cuts deep. Bloodless strokes all, then forward we leap. Bloodless strokes all, then forward we leap. Sword cuts deep. They always think like a whip, but whips do not leave bloodless strokes, and then you leap forward. I have no freaking idea. As per protocol, I have no idea, so we're going to cheat. Grab that conveniently acquired list of solutions. Held firmly. Health. It is a paddle. All right, yeah, I would have I would have never gone to that, but okay. Okay, so let's see what we've got in here. A Mordhall lamprey, some restoratives. Oh, good quality emerald. All right, and glory hand and an herbal pouch. So the majority of the stuff I actually don't care about. Oh, that one, this one's just like legit locked. Let's go ahead and, where is it? Scent of Sarig. Leave it as safe. All right, so what kind of key? No, lock looks complicated. Doesn't know what type of key. Beyond your ability. Will any of our keys, I assume that that means that none of our keys will actually open this. That one broke. That one broke. Nope. All right, Gorath, you're terrible. Let's go back to town really quickly and sell things. I guess, like, at least if they're throwing all this stuff at us right immediately outside of a town, like I said, I can just come back here when I need basically any supplies, sell crap. The system works. No use for such an object, of course. Alright, so noted, he does not buy anything that these guys are dropping. No weapons. I bet he'll buy the glory hand, though. No! Well, buy the emerald. 250 sovereigns for that. That is acceptable. We're looking... I'm feeling comfortable with where our funds are sitting currently. Oh, the place is like a scavenger shop, you know? And I think, like, pawn shop when I hear that. So I'm like, alright, they'll buy everything. And they buy nothing. Well, I mean, we have another town. It's probably gonna be quicker going to CERN to the east. Looks like a shorter walk. Lord knows what's gonna be in our way there, but you know, we can hike it. What's going on? They were not alone. Oh, a lone figure approached, but it became apparent they were not being attacked. Owen relaxed a bit, squinting silently on an attempt to see who it was about to join them.
Our dungeons were not to your liking.
Oh, I was beginning to believe Delacan had slain you. He would be infuriated that you escaped.
You sound eminently pleased at that prospect. Why the charade, Lillian? You can't believe in Delacan's activities any more than I, and yet you support his cause. You command a respectable tribe and have almost as much power.
Almost? Do you forget who engineered your escape from Sargoth all those months ago? Who do you think directed Delacan's rats into the snow plains while Abkar's family scrambled to safety? That was my doing. Not for my help, the Six would surely have crushed your tribes from the Green Heart.
Were you responsible for...
No, I had nothing to do with your escape this time. Whoever you may have done, whatever you may have done, you have achieved it on your own. Your first escape served my purposes, but your continued survival is as nothing to me. It neither threatens nor advances my cause.
Then you will help me again.
I will consider my efforts an investment against the future of the Northlands, Gorath. It will gain me little now, but perhaps at a later day your help may be useful. I will alert my spies to whatever your needs may be. To be honest, I don't believe you will achieve much beyond your own survival, but even that may prove to be my boon. Alright. Here we go. Let's ask about Nalar's Rib.
There have been few occasions I've had to visit Nalar's Rib. I forget its location.
Lies south of here as the crow flies, a few minutes from the front gates of Sargoth. I have not been there in a long while.
Alright, so I'm gonna note that really quick. South of Sargoth. Not a long walk. Alright, Andelicon.
You consort with a monster, Lillian. Tell us a way, then we shall murder him in his sleep. Show us a secret passage, and we shall drink his blood and buy the Mordhall out of their pact of blood.
And what shall become of us? Morolf will then step into his father's place and use our treachery to light the fires under our pursuers. Delacan must fight this battle and our kin die with him on a foreign soil for futile cause. Only then will the other clans who wait to join him know that we cannot unify under a banner of death.
The failure taught them no lesson after the Mermanduce betrayed us in the field, and this shall come to no new conclusion.
We want the same things, Gorath, though I intend to claim what you fear. I will take the throne of the nations of the North when Delacan has fallen to Kingdom Blades. I will lead.
I don't know whether I should laugh or weep at that suggestion, Lillian. But I favor you over his bastard, Get Morwolf. Again, I must seek help in the kingdom. Prince Arutha's army must be there to meet Delacan.
May prove more difficult than you imagine. Delacan has called for Narab's head.
Why should that be? If not for Narab, I would still be loose in the kingdom.
I do not know what fires burn in his mind, but they smoke like madness to me. Narab has called his clan to surround us, though they can be little threat to us here. The Six will crush them hopelessly, but they can restrict us for a time.
The more that Narab plays the fool, the more time it will gain us, though I could wish he were doing it elsewhere. Is there no way past his clan?
Unless you know how to bring down the Dark God's wrath from Nalar's Rib. Can't imagine a way until the Six arrive.
Alright, so I assume in that case then we can't go this way.
What goal does Delacan do this? There can be nothing gained from attacking a single castle on the frontier of the kingdom.
He tells those who rally to him that Mermandamus lives, that he is captive within the kingdom, and that he intends to free him from captivity. None saw him die at Sethanon.
What advantage is there in that for Delacan? Step aside and let Mermandamus retake his place on the throne? I would easier believe you the mistress of death than Delacan, one who longs for his ancient master.
It would seem that there is no one among the Mordhall who thinks. I too have wondered at what he wishes to gain, and I may only conclude he plots to get something from Mermandamus in exchange for freeing him. I had great powers, greater even than the Six who now work for Delacan. Perhaps he believes he can learn the secrets of our former leader's powers.
Whence did Delacan's magicians come? They were spoken of in Harlech before first I left the Northlands. Do they advise?
And more, they plan great schemes into the night with him, meetings to which I am no longer privy. They are the ones who recommend the extermination of your tribe. They speak of the lowborn as if their lives are without value. It is as if they live for the complexities of intrigue. Little else seems to matter for them.
When they buy their wine, with what coins do they bargain?
None. They carry only gems, rubies of low quality. They toss them about as if they were as common as seeds.
They abide in Sargoth?
When they are with Delacan, at the moment they have gone south to Morolf and Harlech. I believe they mean to round up the others of your tribe who have been reluctant to join Delacan's throng.
Alright. Well, I'm saving again. plot has happened. And we're gonna start, I guess, working our way south to Nalar's Rib then. We'll try going this way and see what happens. I'm gonna see if I can at least get to this town over here. Yeah. So we got an attack here. What do we got? Is it just like a trillion? That's only four guys. All right, so this might just be random roach side ambush number 36. Let's see, I'm going here. You here. Oh, come on. All right, Owen, just sit there and defend yourself. Gorath, step here. There. So now Owen can only have one dude beating on him. As Gorath just slowly whittles these guys down. Yeah. That's right, Owen, work up that defensive skill. Gorath, you're terrible. See, now I could be a, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna be a dick. He's trying to run. No one flees from Owen the Great, conjurer of lightning death. Ow. Leave Owen alone. All right, Owen, get out of there. Gorath, entertain. Okay, we're gonna lock this guy down, heal up, and go from there. Actually, looking at the time, I'm probably gonna finish this fight and call it an episode, because we only got 4 minutes left, and I don't think I'm really gonna be able to do too much in that span of time. So, yeah. See what kind of, I'd say see what kind of goodies we get from these guys, but basically I'm just gonna be rifling through their pockets for gold. Okay. Conveniently enough, some of them actually have gold. Grabby crossbows, a rapier, and nothing. All right, there's a fourth one in this, right here maybe? No, maybe, I don't know. There's a fourth one in that mound somewhere, but I don't know where. Yeah, okay, I know I said I was gonna end it. I'm gonna see if we can push forward. Yeah, this is looking like you're getting a fight every couple steps. Oh wow, this is a big one too. All right, same tactic, I guess. Gorath, just step here. And if they're gonna have me in the corner, no one puts baby in a corner, well, Owen in a corner, I guess, except, you know, literally every enemy ever. Seriously, dude? Dude with a crossbow, really? You dicks. Leave my back row alone. Owen, you're very much failing to live up to your ability to defend yourself here, so go ahead and dust this guy. Pocket sand, shishisha. This guy's just hitting his ally more than he's hitting anybody else. It's wonderful. God damn it. I think Owen might be poisoned. I can't tell. Owen, are you poisoned? Owen, poisoned? Yes, okay. Because I was resting him and he wasn't healing. And I should have used a berry there, but I didn't because I'm a genius. And Gorath can't fucking hit anything! Ah! Alright. Crossbow dude, you need to stop. I'm gonna just start hitting you with lightning until you are dead. And Gorath is going to just sit here and soak damage because he can't freaking hit anything. No, don't put it on the ground, Owen. Alright, so he should be down. Yeah. Jesus Christ, Gorath. Owen, go ahead and eat your berries. I'm gonna have to start skulking around for some more of these things because we're running desperately low on them. Oh my god. Whatever. Owen, get out of there. Okay. Rest. Gorath, go here. This guy's gonna be up on his feet here shortly, I think. Maybe not. Maybe this pocket sand lasts a long damn time. Holy crap. I was not expecting it to be like a friggin' 30-point casting of the spell. Who knew, guys? Getting sand in your eyes is gonna lock you down for the, you know, duration of a fight here. Hey, Gorath's actually, he heals 5 points when he rests. That's, I wonder if it's just like a percentage of their max, because Owen heals 4, so maybe it's just like 10% of your max or something. Gorath's abilities have increased. Alright, so is this, I mean, we got more bodies with like just trash loot on them. Is this town right here? I don't know. I don't. All right, whatever. Yeah, there's a town right here. Ha ha! Oh, there's a. Ow. Owen, making Owen wonder, yeah, if they were reinforcements from nearby, yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, what is that? That's a new thing. These are ogres. I don't know what that is. I don't think we can, examine it either. All right. Well, the ogres are slow, so I'm not immediately worried about them chewing on Owen. That having been said, I want to lock down you. I want to lock this guy down. I was going to lock this guy down, but I'm just going to have Gorath maim him, I think. Oh, okay, so that's like an ogre mage type deal then. Okay. Well, I mean, if this one wants to get into Owen's girl, that's fine. I'm just gonna blind it. There you go. Seriously? Uh-uh. None of that bullshit. A for effort. All right, this dude's just chain spamming fireballs for substantial amounts of damage. Gorath, interrupt, please. Owen, hide in a corner somewhere. Yeah, you cheeky bastard. Owen, why don't you lock that guy in back down? He needs to not be running around pitching fireballs. This is almost going to kill Owen, but it's worth it. All right, so yeah, I was gonna say, it's like literally every enemy is just essentially permanently locked down here. So I'm just gonna have Gorath go through while Owen is resting and murder everyone. Can you get down here? No. Can you get up to this one? Half. This thing's far back. And, you know, he can't hit it. Even though he has a 90% chance to hit. Grant's a little slow. Oh my god. This is ridiculous. Like, this is just... I've been bitching about it the entire game. It's not gonna stop you guys. Like, when it is just so egregiously wrong on the hit chances. Yeah, no, that's... me bitching. All right, so now I just want these guys to rest until they're fully healed, which in Owen's case is probably gonna take a little while. I guess that's what he gets for eating two fireballs. All right, so Owen's tapped out. Gorath's been full up for a while. Let's have them both just come down here and flail ineffectually at this ogre. Do we have a corpse for that blue thing? Yes, I think it's right here. What is that? A sentinel ogre. All right. Is that what the other one is too? Yeah. Saying they're both sentinel ogres, even though the other one was blue. Interesting. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and call it here, I think. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I will see you next time when the adventure continues, and I might try pressing onward this direction. I don't know. We'll see how things go. Maybe I'll go poking around. I will probably go for Nalar's Rift, because that seems like the game is telling me, go find this thing and it will help you. So that's probably what I'm gonna do. Until then.